Transport Group Manibela lodges a criminal complaint against officials of transport agencies before the Ombudsman over the PUV modernization program. The group says the officials violated their human rights by implementing the scheme which forces PUV operators to consolidate their franchises and purchase modernized jeepneys. Respondents include Transport Secretary Jaime Bautista, LTFRB Chairman Teofilo Guadis, and Solicitor General Menardo Guevara.
Maraming binayulate ang programa nitong mga opisyal ng DOTR, LTFRB, OTC, at kasama na po dito ang Solicitor General. Inabuso tayo, nilabag ang ating mga karapatan, dineprive ang ating kabuhayan.
As for Transport Secretary Bautista, he says his office has yet to receive a copy of the complaint. But he says they will study the allegations and respond at the appropriate time or forum.
President Marcos underscores his administration's commitment to improving the mass transport system across the country. Marcos attended the 125th founding anniversary of the Department of Transportation and the ceremonial signing of the civil works contracts for the Davao Public Transport Modernization Project. He touted the project as a game changer that will provide a template to building public transport systems in other cities.
This is more than just a ceremonial signing for the civil works of contracts for the Davao Public Transport Modernization Project. It is a strong reaffirmation of our commitment to develop the Davao region. It is a demonstration of our resolve to deliver what people in all regions deserve, a mass transportation system that can move commuters and commerce efficiently. There is no better place than this city to renew the pledge that there is no better time than today.
Earlier in the day, President Marcos, in a separate event, led the distribution of e-titles to land reform beneficiaries in Davao City. Let's now go to the latest jobs reports here at home. Philippine unemployment falls further. At the end of 2023, the number stood at 3.1% in December, or at 1.6 million Filipinos out of work. This was down from the 3.6%, or the 1.83 million jobless persons in November. It's also lower than the 4.3% in December 2022. However, underemployment continued to rise, coming in at nearly 12%. Those who have jobs but still look for extra working hours climbed to over 6 million in December. Let's break down the numbers per sector. The services industry had the highest number of jobs, making up 57% of total employment. The construction sector, meanwhile, saw the most number of additional workers at 777,000. According to Manila Statistics Bureau, the current employment and unemployment rates are the lowest in nearly two decades.
This is the highest since 2005. No, the same with the unemployment rate, 3.1%. This is also the lowest since 2005.
The government's chief economist, Secretary Arsenio Balisacan, welcomes the December jobs print. He says their focus remains on creating high-paying and quality jobs to address gaps in the labor sector. Balisacan also says government will beef up social and physical infrastructure investments to improve human capital and create more employment opportunities. Most Asian markets in Asia are climbing following a positive lead from Wall Street overnight. The major U.S. indices closed in the green Tuesday as investors examine more earnings reports. This also came even after cautious comments from some Fed policymakers. Minneapolis Fed President Neel Kashkari said the U.S. Central Bank is not done yet with inflation. He, however, noted inflation came down quickly. Meanwhile, Cleveland Fed President Loretta Mester said she was not ready yet to suggest timing for easier policy due to inflation uncertainty. Fed Chair Jerome Powell, in a TV interview on Sunday, said the Fed will exercise prudence in deciding when to cut rates. Let's look at the board now. South Korea's Kospi Index is leading today's rally, jumping by over 1%. The ASX 200 also closed higher a day after Australia's central bank held its rates steady. Let's take a look now at futures in Europe. They are flat ahead of economic data across the region. The list includes Germany's industrial production numbers and France's trade figures. Over on Wall Street, futures are also muted ahead of more Fed speak. Corporate earnings also in focus, with Disney, Uber, and PayPal set to report.
Let's take a look at corporate stories now. Globe Telecom closes out 2023 with marginally lower core net income. It stood at 18.19 billion pesos, down by 8% from the 19.16 billion in 2022. Quarter on quarter, though, it declined by 15%, or from 4.8 billion pesos in quarter three to 4.1 in the final 3 months of last year. Still, the telco giant's revenues were up by 3%. Main drivers of growth were mobile business revenues at over 112 billion pesos, along with corporate data and non-telco services revenues. Globe share in equity earnings of GCash parent Mint last year also grew to 2.4 billion pesos. Frutas Holdings opens three new branches of its Lingnam restaurants in Metro Manila. The firm says the expansion is part of its commitment to provide quality dining experiences and to strengthen its presence in the food industry. The Frutas Group acquired the Chinese restaurant chain in 2022. Also today, First Gen Corporation confirms receiving the Competition Commission's approval to buy the Quezon Hydroelectric Power Plant in Nueva Ecija Province. The price tag was at $526 million, or nearly 30 billion pesos. The antitrust body cleared the acquisition of the plant by First Gen subsidiary Fresh River from a state-owned firm and the National Irrigation Administration. And finally, DMCI and Cemex Holdings clarify a report on a supposed undertaking between the two companies. DMCI says it continues to evaluate plans to venture into the cement business. It disputed an online report which talked of rumors DMCI is taking over a subsidiary of Cemex. Cemex, meanwhile, says that while it's looking at divestment opportunities, it has no knowledge on the report.